My name is Deborah Fayroyan. I'm director of Chamber Music North, and today's program on our Sundays at 3 series is the final concert in our 2010 lineup of incredible performers. The Fry Street Quartet is the featured work today, and they have chosen a wonderful program depicting the romantic composers who wrote for string quartet, beginning with Ludwig van Beethoven and one of his earlier compositions in the Opus 18. It is an extraordinary, young, energetic work. It ushered in the entire Romantic period. Ending the concert, and I'll jump ahead, is an incredible work by Antonin Dvorak. This is subtitled The American Quartet. It was written during a brief stay that Dvorak had in this country, the United States, where he was director of the National Conservatory of Music in New York City, a very radical and incredibly wonderful idea that lasted about 40 years, I believe, in New York City. It was to have a federally funded list of conservatories across the country. The philanthropic idea was the brainchild of Jeanette Thurber, who was a wealthy socialite living in the 1700s and 1800s in this country. The middle of this program is a work by Samuel Barber, an extraordinary American composer, very recent and the most recent of the three composers today. Samuel Barber was a phenomenal talent. He worked in New York City as well. He died in 1981, quite recently. And his string quartet is an extraordinary work, still within the Romantic period, but you see already some shades of new compositional ideas and techniques that were coming forward by composers here. Fry Street Quartet is in residence at the Kane School for the Arts in Utah, at Utah State University.
William Fedkin Hoyer, I'm the first violinist in the Fry Street Quartet, and I've been, the first finalist of the quartet for about, I think this is my fifth season now.
I'm Rebecca McFall. I play second violin in the Fry Street Quartet, and I am indeed the only remaining founding member of the quartet.
My name is Brad Otteson, and I'm the violist of the quartet. And I'm more of a recent arrival with the group. I came in this season.
I'm Anne Francis, and I'm the cellist of the Fry Street Quartet. I've been in the quartet for almost 10 years. The quartet's been in existence for about 12 years, so I came along in the early years.
The quartet was founded in Chicago.
And Fry Street, for those folks who know Chicago, is actually one block north of Chicago Avenue, which is the street with the water tower.
It was a quartet that had founded the residency at Utah State University in Logan, Utah, where we live now. And they had just disbanded, and so that residency had just opened up, and they had asked for applications. So the quartet applied, and the quartet was part of a group of, I believe, four finalists, and each quartet came out, and we were lucky enough to be selected.
It's a program that we chose because of the American connection. Of course, the Barber Quartet, Samuel Barber, is one of the best-known American composers of the last century. And of course, pairing that with the Dvorak American makes a nice tie. This piece earned its nickname because Dvorak was living in the United States when he wrote it. And it's interesting because Dvorak really was very interested in finding native music in his home country, then Czechoslovakia. And when he came to the United States, he was interested in finding out, is there such a thing as American music? Does the United States have its own native music? And it's really interesting what he discovered, because it was not necessarily what the Americans at the time wanted to hear, which was that there was a lot of Native American music and African American music that he uses in this quartet, some of it more obvious than others. And it makes a nice tie with the Barber, because they both use these kind of open harmonies, I think, that sort of tie together, which is nice. And of course, early Beethoven is fantastic. We've played all of the Beethoven quartets. Just did our first Beethoven cycle a couple of years ago. So nothing works better as an opener than Opus 18 number 6, just this bright, sparkling first movement. And so it works well together. It's got a nice flow.
Without further delay, I introduce to you Fry Street Quartet. Enjoy the concert.
Thank you. Thank you.
Barber's String Quartet, which is of course most famous for its iconic slow movement, because that seems to show up in our lives often during times of tragedy, like was it used at the commemoration of the World Trade Center tragedy, at funerals for President Roosevelt, President Kennedy. We all know and love this work. But we don't often hear it in its proper context. It was originally written as part of Barber's only string quartet, which he wrote as a young man, I think of him as a strapping young man, traipsing through Europe after having won the Prix de Rome in 1936. And we thought it would be interesting just to take you through a little bit of how the piece is crafted. The more we work on it, the more I see how every motive and element that he uses in the outset of the first movement gets played with, and it shows up in many, many permutations. It's based on really this very first theme, which we'll share for you, which is basically just a chromatic meandering ascending scale.
Dvorak's American Quartet is probably really one of the true gems of the string quartet literature. It was given its nickname because it was written during the time that Dvorak was living in the United States. Specifically, during a summer sojourn that he had in a very small town in Iowa called Spillville. It was a small Czech community there, and he went there for a few months one summer as sort of a retreat from big city life. He was living in New York at the time, running a music school there. And it's interesting because this time that Dvorak spent in Iowa has been sort of romanticized over the years by musicologists and by those of us who read about it. But in fact, he really didn't enjoy his time in Iowa at all. He sort of felt like the folks there were kind of rubes and that he was too sophisticated for them. He fancied himself a sophisticated guy, and so it was interesting because although it's the music is very lush and warm and very friendly and open, he himself wasn't having such a good time. But it's a fun piece because he was spending some time thinking about native music. He did this a lot in his home country of Czechoslovakia. He was interested in native melodies, folk melodies. So he wanted to know, is there such a thing as American native music? And what he came up with was influences from some Native American music, Native American Indians, some African American melodies. He even uses bird song in the third movement of the quartet. There was a scarlet tanager that lived in the tree outside his bedroom window, and it drove him crazy waking him up every morning with this. Thank you, Will. It's an incredibly inventive movement, actually. Because he takes that melody and he uses it in all different kinds of ways. You'll hear it in the cello, down really low and really loud. You'll hear it in the violin, very soft. And it's really quite interesting. He takes it into minor in the middle of the movement, all from this darn bird that lived in his tree. So the first movement opens with a very, very recognizable viola melody. Will be played beautifully by Brad. The second movement is a very mournful, slow movement. You will hear a lot of back and forth between the first violin and the cello in that movement. The third movement is basically a minuet and trio or a scherzo and trio, and that's where you'll hear the bird song. And the last movement is a rousing finale. He actually wrote sketches for this movement while on the train leaving Spillville. And you will hear a lot of joy and also a very characteristic rhythm that sounds like the train moving, the wheels of the train. So please enjoy Dvorak's American Quartet. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
what's fun about being in a quartet is we are very close, and we spend far too much time together. And so all of those little things that you really don't want anyone to know, we all know.
Will Feckenheuer is a championship country fiddler.
We're going home.